Hello, folks. How are ya? I'm doing just great. It's so hot outside here. It's hot for, you know, a day. And what month is it right now? In May. It's hot for a May 17 in Canada here. Maybe not for you guys, but it is for me. Like, well, maybe you live in Alaska and it's always cold. And if you do, can I come visit? Because Alaska looks so cool. And no pun. And or maybe you live in like California or something, or in Mexico. And also, can I come visit there? Because that sounds pretty dope. But anyway, it's nice out here. I'm pretty stoked. We're going to look at this blur tool, and you're going to like it. It's a pretty trippy little device. And the more I play with it, the more I'm finding ways to screw with it. And that's really all anything is about these days, is screwing with stuff inside a Bitwig. Okay? All right. Stay tuned. Let's have a look. Okay, you might recognize this from the video that's called Making Your Drums Even Drummier, and that's just this, listen. Right, okay, so now I'm gonna add the blur to it. I'm gonna delete the blur and bring it in fresh so that it is, we're all on the same page here. Okay, there it is, fresh. Let's have a listen. Without. And with. Okay, so what exactly am I looking at? Let's ignore the fact that it's called comb for a sec, okay? That's just confusing, frankly. And let's observe the fact that we have two dots called R and two called L. And basically all this is a graph that shows you how loud one of these dots are, from as loud as it can go to as quiet as it can go. And it's also showing you an L, for that's your left speaker. And then you'll notice here it says 1 millisecond, and there it says 10 milliseconds. So if I were to bring this up here, for example, that would mean one of the two dots that I get from my left speaker is delaying, I don't know, what is this? 55 milliseconds, and it's quite loud. And that's basically it. Whoa, I just deleted it. What the hell, man? Oh no, there we go. That was so weird. Wait, if you double click it, that's so weird, right? Okay, anyway, don't double click it unless you want them to be 1 second. But basically, I'm gonna turn these down, all right? And let's listen to just one left speaker dot. Pretty bizarre. And so what you notice is as I get this thing closer to the left, closer to 1 millisecond, it's actually making a tone. And that's because it's so close together. It's a delay, essentially, that is so close together that it's making its own tone. And the reason is because if you vibrate anything fast enough, it'll make a tone, right? Because all sound is the vibration of molecules. And the vibration, well, I guess the acoustic version is the vibration of air molecules. But essentially, if I bring this really close together, it's going to make a tone because it's just that close together that it's vibrating fast enough to make that tone. Let's listen again. Pretty insane, right? Okay, so, and that's really all you need to know in a nutshell, is that when you move this dot, if it's an L dot, it's your left speaker, and you're just moving it in a graph that tells you the loudness of it versus the delay between the original signal and the delayed signal. Over here is all the way to 200 milliseconds, although apparently if you double click them, they go to 1 second. Which is news to me. And if otherwise, you can just bring it up and the highest it goes is 200 milliseconds, which is very strange. I'm glad that I learned that because that's pretty bizarre. And then you can set different values for both speakers. So let's bring in the right And let's say, let's put one right speaker dot over here and one left speaker dot over there. And then we'll just see what happens. I'm just saying, my brain is thinking right now, how can I add in a mod that's going to make all these dots just cycle around in a circle, because that's going to be cool. But, you know, it's almost Friday. I guess by the time you watch this, it might be. I don't remember. Anyway, and we're going to get weird, and we're probably going to do this, but let's just listen. So with the blur tool, wow, man, this thing is bizarre. You can basically make it so it's like almost a reverb, but not really. It's like a really grainy sounding reverb. I'm just saying, if you add this to a reverb, I gotta do it now, damn it. If you add this to a reverb, you're getting very close, probably, in my estimation, you will be getting close to sounding like a Valhalla Shimmer. But you know what? I'm going to add it on an effects track. Let's just see. Doobity-bop-ba-da-bump-a-doo. Adding some blur onto my reverb. Wait, what happened there? Nope, I'm adding some reverb onto my blur. Boobity-bop-ba-da. Okay. All right. Let's turn this sucker up. Put it on post. Let's solo it. Know what I'm saying? I know you do. That's the blur right there. A simple little device that delays two dots per speaker, essentially. Okay? Don't get confused by this comb. I'm not going to explain that because, you don't need to know it. You just need to know that you get two dots per speaker, and then you can move them in the graph. That is a graph of volume versus time. Okay. All right, guys. I hope you enjoyed that one. It was short and sweet. I think it was anyway. And we'll see you in the next video, which is getting weird. And we're definitely going to use the blur. That's all I'm going to say. And we're probably going to use the amp. Okay. That's all. That's all I'm going to say. Well, probably not. You know what? No. No, that's all I'm going to tell you. I was thinking that maybe we could throw... No. No. You'll have to click it and see. All right. All right. Good job.